Hi everyone, first I want to chat with you. Our main subject today is about sweep gas or sweeping gas membrane distillation performance model. It's about a special type of membrane distillation. As we know, we have different types of membrane distillations, such as direct contact, air gap, vacuum membrane distillation, and sweep gas membrane distillation. First of all, open your MATLAB. Okay, this is your MATLAB interface, and try to go to your destination folder from, and don't open your model from desktop, just copy it after you download it from REDS library. Copy it into your model folder or main working folder, and go to open MATLAB and go to your destination folder. This is my working folder, for example. Okay, this is my working folder, and I have to go to my my model folder from here. So this is my model folder, open it. Okay, this is my path, and click here to sort by name and to group by type, and so you will find your files and references are well organized here. And then double clicking or drag and drop here. Okay, so this is your model folder. And okay, how can we run this? Okay, first of all, set your simulation time into zero. Okay, and double clicking here. Okay, this is our main menu. I would like to assign some main inputs related to my cost, design, and operating conditions. For my cost analysis, I would like to assign my interest rate, plant lifetime, load factor, symbol. And then we have to assign some design parameters, such as area. What is your membrane area? Because this is your performance model, it is not a design. So my membrane area, for example, it's say 2 modules or 3 modules, it's up to you. And what is your membrane porosity? What is your contact angle? Okay, membrane thickness. Okay, and membrane pore diameter. Okay, and salinity. What is your salinity ratio? Is it brackish water? It is. Is it seawater? It's up to you. Suppose I have 25,000. Okay, part per million. Okay, this is my target salinity ratio. Suppose I'm targeting around 200 or 250. As a normal value of product salinity ratio, and bumping efficiency for feed stream. Okay, and let's go for operating conditions. We have hot side temperature. Okay, so we can change this, and permeate temperature or cold side temperature. Okay, and reference temperature, actually it is for exergy analysis calculations. And let me check here. Okay, it is for exergy analysis, and air mass flow rate, because we have here air mass flow rate through the process. A specific gas constant, because we're dealing with exergy analysis and air, and molecular weight of your water site. Okay, let's saving. Let's go inside here from this menu. Okay, these are our main outputs. Let's hit run and see. Under the current specifications, just an example. It is not in more details. Okay, so now we have here feed exergy, brine exergy, product exergy destruction rate, bumping power, specific bulk consumption, membrane thermal power, thermal efficiency, GOR, feed flow rate, and let's go here. Okay, feed flow rate, brine loss flow rate, membrane conductivity, brine loss salinity, and concentration factor, water recovery factor, and permeate flux, and permeability coefficients, and cost. Here we can unit product cost, total annual cost, and capital tire cost. Okay, suppose I would like to, if you can change here, let's go here, and we can for example make it only one unit and see the results. Okay, hit run again. So if you okay, changing mean pressure, liquid entry pressure, and so on. Okay, suppose I would like to study the effect of a specific parameter, maybe a conductivity, for example. Let's see here, or porosity, maybe membrane thickness. Okay, conductivity should be calculated. Okay, anyway, I would like to inspect the effect of some important parameters, maybe temperature, for example, this one. So I would like to save this. Let's save this to as save as, and maybe another version, VD. Okay, I'm not going to change this. I'll change the effect automatically. So this is another one. Okay, let's go here, and temperature, hot side temperature. Let's see if I change this hot side temperature. So I will remove this one, Control X, and put it here and comment it. So there is no effect here. If you go here inside and try to change this, there is no effect because I disconnected. Okay, and let's go here and let's go for sources. I can use clock, or I can use a signal builder if I would like to create my signal by myself. Let's see if I choose this, a signal builder. Okay, drag and drop. Okay, but not here. I would like to put it out here. Okay, put it here. I will try to create my signal by myself, and let's see if I get another source. Let's see from here. Yes, input, and connect this one. So this is my inlet hot side temperature, T hot N. Okay, and let it be degrees Celsius. And let's go out. So if you'd like to inspect, just right click, going to the mask, edit mask, and select this one, opaque ports, hit apply, and okay. So just to be sure that your connection is right to your specific parameter that you'd like to study. This is operating conditions block. I can surely add many parameters. Simulation time. I would like to change the simulation time. Considering the x-axis is my temperature, so let's begin from 40 degrees Celsius up to 65. Variable step. Okay. Let's reduce my okay. No change here, no change. Saving. Okay, I would like to build my my parameters, my hot side temperature from 40 to 65. To be sure, let's hit okay. Signal. Let's go for replace this by custom. Okay, my time is from 40, let it be step 0.5 up to 65, and the same for the temperature. This is my I'm sorry, I have to change my time. It is from 40 up to 65, and let's head back again and change my simulation x-axis. Okay, so this is my, I would like to make it more fit. Let it be 0.1, okay. And so this is my time or x-axis, okay. And this is okay. Saving, signal name is T hot in degrees Celsius. Okay, saving, close this one, and now we can save and hit run. And be sure to send your result to data inspector. Okay, highlight this. Please select this small square to send your result to data inspector and hit run. Okay, finished. Let's go on for inspection. Okay, click here. Okay, let's draw some parameters here to see the effect of hot side temperature. Direct cost, no change because it is not function of temperature. Okay, this is unit product cost. A number of pores constant, exergy of your feed, exergy of your brine, and mass flow rate of the brine, product mass flow rate increasing. So this is the effect of your hot side temperature, brine salinity. Let's add more slots. We have a results here, so okay, and brine salinity. Okay, brine salinity increasing, so coefficient factor, water recovery ratio, okay, interesting, pressure, and so on. And is power, let's see the power. Power, yes, power increasing, specific power consumption, and so on. So this is your effect of your hot side temperature. So yeah, you can add more changes to your model and you can inspect your results. Send data to your figure. You can click here and send your result to your to a figure in MATLAB, and I just click here and let's see. Okay, so this is my plot panel, so I can control my control my interface. This is background white. I can change my lines here. Let's see, increase the thickness, change the line figure, line color, and you can also, for example, x-axis is not your time, x-axis is your T hot in degrees Celsius. So this is your font size. I think it is Times New Roman for your scientific paper. And okay, 12. So it's up to you. You can handle your figures. You can change your color. For example, here we can just make this dotted. Okay. And you can handle your result for your research activity. Finally, I would like to thank you very much for your interest in our model. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Thank you very much.